Ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues, as President and Vice-Chancellor of the University of Bath, I'm delighted to welcome you all here this evening, and particularly to welcome you to the Gerald Waters Lecture. But first, it's my most pleasing duty to commend Sir Anthony Seldon, who will be accepting the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters today. An honorary degree is the highest accolade the university can bestow. In celebrating the 50th anniversary of the granting of our Royal Charter by Her Majesty the Queen this year, we will be recognizing over 60 remarkable people in this way. Many of these honorary degrees will be conferred during our summer and winter degree ceremonies, as is customary. But 27 will be conferred at events such as this one over the course of the next year. In a press article in 2015, Sir Anthony was described as a one-man whirlwind of activity and achievement. How true this is. Amongst other things, and in no particular order, what's he doing behind my back there? In no particular order, a political historian, of course, a commentator on British political leadership, education, and contemporary Britain, Vice-Chancellor of the University of Buckingham, a Fellow of the Royal Historical Society and King's College London, a Governor of the Royal Shakespeare Company. He has been knighted by Her Majesty the Queen in the 2014 Birthday Honours List for services to education and modern political history. He founded the Festival of Education and the Festival of Higher Education. He served on the First World War Centenary Culture Committee, and last but not least, certainly, has promoted happiness, well-being, and mindfulness across education. Sir Anthony's commentary on the purpose of education espouses the view that academic attainment, whilst important, is only part of the picture. He values education, which challenges and stimulates the student, as well as developing curiosity, resilience, and responsibility. It would be difficult, I would argue, for anyone to argue against this premise. Certainly at Bath, we have sought to create a nurturing environment for enterprising minds. I am in no doubt that this has been the key to our success in teaching and research, our high levels of student satisfaction and employment, and our recognition on both the national and international stage. We are consequently very pleased that Sir Anthony has joined us today to receive his honour and to give the Gerald Waters 46th Memorial Lecture. So, without further ado, we will now start the formal ceremony. By my authority as Vice-Chancellor, I declare this congregation open for the conferment of an honorary degree. I call upon the University Orator to present a candidate for a degree honoris causa.
Sir Anthony Seldon is one of the country's leading educationalists and also one of our foremost political historians and analysts. In both fields, he has made an outstanding contribution that has inspired his fellow educationists and provided penetrating and timely insights into the state of politics in the United Kingdom. The breadth and depth of his contributions demonstrate his commitment and passion for education and public life indeed. Sir Anthony graduated with an MA in Politics, Philosophy and Economics from Oxford and a PhD from the London School of Economics. Given this intellectual background, we might have expected him to enter politics, as many have done before him and indeed since. However, it is typical of Sir Anthony that that politics was not his immediate destination. Instead, he undertook a PGCE at King's College, London, leading to a distinguished career with appointments to top public schools in England, including as headmaster of Brighton College and the 13th master of Wellington College. Under him, both were rated the most improved schools by A-level results in Britain. Currently, he is Vice Chancellor of the University of Buckingham. In itself, such a career would be noteworthy, but Sir Anthony's has been distinguished by innovation in his concern to address some of the pressing practical problems confronting education. His commitment to challenging tasks extends into areas of debate and possible controversy. For example, he has asked the philosophic question, should schools be teaching happiness? He answered that question for himself in typical hands-on fashion by seeking to teach for happiness at Wellington College. We should note how important taking a lead in this area is because young people are finding the world an increasingly difficult place. Encouraging them to develop ways of coping so that they can feel more at home is clearly important, not only for their educational careers, but their subsequent lives. So important does he consider this challenge to be that he founded Action for Happiness with Lord Layard, an eminent economist, and as president of the International Positive Education Association. At least two more of his many innovations in education are noteworthy. He championed the International Baccalaureate at Wellington, seeing it as a qualification fit for the 21st century. Here we should note that in this he is at one with our colleagues at Bath who have been so influential in the development of the IB. He has been greatly concerned about the divide between public and state schools. In characteristic manner, not only has he written about this topic, but has also played a key role in establishing the Wellington Academy, a state-funded comprehensive school in Tidworth and Wiltshire. In choosing his current role at the University of Buckingham, he continues a commitment to innovation. Buckingham is the only independent university in the United Kingdom with a royal charter. If there is a link between his activities as an educator and his political interests, it is that he has advised and commented on education policy. To do so much in education is, in itself, the mark of a distinguished career. To do this, he has added to the role of a distinguished, he's added that of the role of a distinguished historian. He is the author of some of the most significant books to have been written on contemporary British politics and co-founded the first direct and been the first director of the Institute for Contemporary History. He has written over 35 books, including high-profile work on the four last prime ministers that we have had. There are several notable qualities that distinguish this work. It is in the finest traditions of British empiricism, focusing on the day-to-day challenges that these prime ministers have had to confront, and written with clarity and with clear judgment, as well as the clarity in style. In this year's performed a service for posterity, for the interviews which form the bedrock for his analysis will be available to future historians and to those that will place these interviews within a broader theoretical framework. The work means that future historians will have in their possession invaluable insights into what the world looked like from the perspectives of these politicians. The lessons that historians will extract will be tempered by their understanding of the perspectives that Sir Anthony and his colleagues have drawn from their subjects. But Sir Anthony's work is characterized by a lack of partisan politics. His judgments are even-handed. This brings us to two of the most noteworthy qualities in Sir Anthony's contributions to public life. His work is finely balanced, seeking to understand the world from different perspectives, and it is collegial. He has always collaborated with others, even when his innovations have pushed at the educational and political boundaries. It is to his great credit that in these endeavors, his work has been embraced by many from across educational and political divides. Finally, he exemplifies the one quality all educators must have, an optimism that the problems of this world can be addressed. Vice Chancellor. I present to you Sir Anthony Seldon, who is eminently worthy to receive the degree of Doctor of Letters, honoris causa.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Letters, honoris causa. Congratulations.
So, Vice Chancellor, distinguished senior members of the University of Bath, and ladies and gentlemen, it is deeply honouring to receive a degree, an honorary degree from the university, especially in the 50th year of this great, great university. Thank you to the orator for those very generous words. And when I was listening to you, I was thinking I wish my wife had been here, because if she had heard these things, she might have a greater generosity and understanding about why I'm not always more helpful around the house and with practical things. Regrettably, she has cancer and is too unwell, and that is an interesting life experience for all of us. We all have difficult things to deal with in our lives. I spoke about it quite recently on Desert Island Discs. And part of the optimism approach that we heard about there is to deal with everything that life throws at us with gratitude and with a sense of humility and trying to learn from whatever life throws, even if it's not ideal. So I would just like to say, just very briefly, a few words about the Vice Chancellor, because I'm talking tonight about leadership. And leadership is very interesting. Most leaders manage. And to be a manager is important and valuable, but it's not leadership. And when the Vice Chancellor came to Bath 15 years ago, the university was some 7,000, and it now has some 17,000, well over twice the size. And it was in the 30s, roughly, amongst university rankings. I rather wish my university was in the 30s. And it's now in the top 10, and it has outstanding reputations in so many fields. And as a head of a pretty academic school, I was very proud to send large numbers of tremendous quality students here in the sciences, in psychology, in economics. And they have had the most tremendous time at the University of Bath. And I follow my students very carefully over 20 years of being a head, and I notice the different experiences that they have. And they thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it and felt proud to be at a university which is in the top 12 or so at research, which has this outstanding employability record, outstanding student satisfaction. And as I've seen tonight, in actually my first visit up here, though it Bath is our favourite, my wife's my favourite city in England. My first visit to the university, just astonishingly beautiful, and I'm sure that just enhances the experience they have. So thank you so much. I'm more touched and proud than I can say to be standing before you here, and what a wonderful idea to have for your 50th anniversary, celebrating the people as you are. Thank you, Vice Chancellor, thank you, senior members of the university, and I look forward to talking to all of you and finding out why today has been a slightly frazzled day with the news. More on that at the lecture.
I now declare this congregation closed for the conferment of degrees. If you would like to stand while we go out, we will return. But I promise you we won't be quite so colourful when we return. So please do stand, and we should have some music to exit by.